Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today I'm going to show you yet another thermal scan above Iceland's highway number one, the ring road, or where it runs over the edge of the volcano Hengill that is situated on the plate boundaries, but in this case it's very close to Reykjavik. And as usual, this is my main scanning area, this road embankment, and we can see the volcano Hengill in the background. And let's swap to thermal view, higher up than usual. And on the left side of the frame, we have a known geothermal area, and it has been expanding under the road and even further south. And if the road embankment wasn't so thick there, the heat would have ruined the road already. But it does, however, have a special road cooling system. The road administration, they drilled some holes in it and placed steam pipes there, venting out some of the steam and cooling the road. And that has actually worked just fine. If not, the road surface would be way hotter than it is now. While I was staying in Reykjavik recently, I got the best possible conditions for a thermal scan. It was very cold, but not enough snow to interrupt what the drone was seeing. And the last scan before this was in October, but the conditions were not as good as now, and I was looking for more accuracy. So what I was aiming at now was a wider shot from higher up. So this is a good angle to compare, and the cold made all the heat spots pop out big time, leaving me with fairly good idea about the big picture. And the surprise of the day was this part of the road. It was just so much going on there, way more than I've seen before. And I actually mentioned this little fracture in my last update that runs under the road. But this time, I was detecting spots just all over the place there. So it's way more going on south of the road than I expected. But those results might have something to do with the extra good conditions. But I am at least now interpreting this as increased ground temperature. But I live over 400 kilometers away, so I can't be too picky when it comes to weather conditions when I'm driving by every few months usually. And this is just a part of my learning curve with the thermal drone. Those seven eruptions this year alone turned out to be a big task, so many of my long-term goals are still on hold. But due to the conditions by the hot road this time, I just had to see what the drone could see. And when I came across this big hotspot that actually did not need any thermal camera to be detected due to all the steam coming from it, I thought for a while that I had a new finding there. But when I started to prepare for this video, I did see this spot in my thermal scan last January. So this is not exactly a new finding, but to see all this steam coming from this spot, I have not seen that before. Although I have done a few tours when the conditions were very steamy, and actually of that kind that I was using the filming drone to chase steam spots. And I should have detected this steam spot back then. But after the thermal scan, I picked up the other drone to do the close-ups. And I had lots of fun due to the contrasts or steam coming up from the icy ground. And then we had the green moss popping out through the snow. And this is the kind of footage that I go after to upload to video stock sites. It's a hard market and oversaturated in many categories. So this is the kind of footage that I'm looking for. Something I can connect with the energy. And I also noticed that close to those steam vents, it was plenty of grass there since last summer. But with this heat we see now, spots like this tend to turn into mud. So it looks to me that this area hasn't been as hot as it was now for a very long time. But I would need the local information for that. So that is my next step. But I am, however, very sure that the ground heat there is gradually increasing and the geothermal area is getting larger. But I don't see that as a sign of something drastic on their way. But it is this location that makes this so interesting. And also the timing, because this area is generally categorized as one of the systems on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And when one of them takes off, like by Grindavík, the others will follow, according to history. So for curious minds with interest in geology, it's very tempting to come up with all sorts of theories to connect this with the ongoing series of events by Grindavík. And earthquakes in this region are also quite frequent. But Icelandic experts, they have kept their cool during all this. And they talk about those changes as general changes in the geothermal reservoir there. It's an answer that can't backfire and a bit dull for many of us who want lots of information when we find hot stories like this. But as for the wider picture, this area is the main energy source for Reykjavík. This is where we harvest all the hot juices to heat up our houses and to drive the turbines to produce electricity, and we have two power plants there. The plan was to build the third one, but the geothermal reservoir under there, it was draining faster than expected, so energy from the third area that we see here, it is used today to keep one of the other power plants from powering down, and that is done with pipelines. So we have many reasons to be on the lookout, because this is very important area as for our infrastructure, especially when it comes to cold land like ours. And this is not a question about whether if the volcano Hengill will erupt again. That is just a matter of time, but we could have to wait for a long time. This system has proven to be a teaser, but also this excellent practice area for the thermal drone. And I actually would have preferred to have used it more, but that might change this winter, since we might have to wait for 3 months or even longer for the next eruption on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And I live just by the north part of the plate boundaries, and I already have a list of places that might look very interesting with the thermal camera. And as for the story about the hot road, my next filming tour will be most likely when I'm back to the Reykjanes Peninsula and getting the right conditions for a thermal scan. But I would also like to do a thermal scan over some of the old and the new lava around Grindavík to see how fast or slow the cooling process is. And I would have done that during my last trip if it wasn't so windy. I'm just very cheap when it comes to flying the drone with the thermal camera, because the mistakes I could do there, they are just too expensive. And I plan to use it for a long, long time. And finally, feel free to come up with ideas for the thermal drone. And it doesn't have to be lava or hot water. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.